गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड हाउ टू डिवाइड टू पॉलिनोमियल्स. सो मूविंग ऑन, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द रिमाइंडर थ्योरम, दैट हाउ शुड वी अप्लाई द रिमाइंडर थ्योरम इंस्टेड ऑफ लॉन्ग डिवीजन मेथड इन अ पॉलिनोमियल. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव डन यस्टरडे, दैट इज़ वी हैव डिवाइडेड दिस टू पॉलिनोमियल्स एंड बाय सॉल्विंग इट आवर रिमाइंडर वॉज -5. नाउ मूविंग ऑन, दैट हाउ शुड वी अप्लाई द रिमाइंडर थ्योरम इन दिस क्वेश्चन. We will study it today. So, as you can see, this was our question. The question was that you have to divide this polynomial by this x minus 1. So, after dividing, we have seen that our remainder was minus 5. And this was our quotient. And this was our remainder. So, the proper long division method, you can see it is time consuming. So there is a one short method for this. So what is this? You can see here the remainder was minus 5, and as you have seen that this is the divisor. So what you have to do, you just have to see that if you make the divisor 0, that is the divisor is x minus 1, that if you make divisor 0, then what should be the value of x here? If you make x minus 1 0, so for this the value of x here should be 1, because 1 minus 1 is 0. Okay, so you can see that if we have to make this value 0, we should put here 1. So we can say here the value of x is equals to 1. So now if you put the value, this value of x in this dividend, so after solving this polynomial by putting the value x is equals to 1, whatever the value you will get, that value will be the remainder. So for checking it, let us see what we have done here. What we have done, 0 of the polynomial, that is this was our divisor, iska 0 kya hoga? 1. 0 of polynomial means the value at which the polynomial becomes 0. So it's 0 is 1. Now if we divide, so here I have written that if we divide this polynomial by this, so the whatever our result will be, the result will be equal to the value if we put x is equals to 1 here. This I have written in words here, that is if we divide this polynomial by x minus 1, so the result will be equal to if we place the value of 0 of polynomial in this equation. For its verification, let us see what we have done. It's x minus 1 has a 0, 1. 0, 1 means at 1 its value will be 0. So what we have done here, we just have put the value 1 in this polynomial. After putting the value 1, what we have get? 3, minus 4, minus 3 and minus 1. So after solving this, what is the final result? That is minus 5. So minus 5 is the answer that we get by the long division method and also by the short method. So which method is more time consuming? Obviously the short method is time consuming. So that's why there is a need of remainder theorem. In this we just have to put the value of x, that is the 0 of the polynomial. We just have to put the value of 0 of the polynomial. So this was a short method, the how to apply remainder theorem. So now you can see here. Okay, so this was our polynomial and this was our divisor, and as you know the relation between dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder I have written here. And what we have done now, we have put the value of x is equals to 1. So what you have to do, you just have now, okay, how now you can say that, ma'am, how can we say that this 5 is the remainder? The question arises that how can we say that this 5 is the remainder? This I have written here. Suppose I haven't mentioned it here, then how can you say that this 5 is the remainder? So for it we have done a proof here, because this is the dividend, divisor into quotient plus remainder. This is the divisor. We have solved here the value of x is equals to 1, and by putting x is equals to 1 on both sides, what we will get? Here we have put 1 in every value of x. Also, if we put here x is equals to 1 and quotient and remainder are as it is, so 1 minus 1 is 0, so we will get this quotient term 0 here, because 0 into something is 0. Okay, Now what we are left with, we have left with the dividend is equals to this first term is 0 and remainder. So we can say that after putting the value of x here, whatever value will be get will be equal to the remainder. So this is the proof that how can we say the value will be remainder. Okay. In this we just have done, we just have put the value of 0 of the polynomial into the dividend and we have just solved it. Now coming on to what actually remainder theorem is. Remainder theorem, what it states? It states that if Px is any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1, this is the condition, Px is any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1. The degree of polynomial should be greater than or equal to 1. This is the condition here. Now, if A be any real number, if Px is divided by the linear polynomial x minus A, then remainder is Pa. This is the statement of the remainder theorem. This might be confusing to you. So, let us understand it by an example. It would be more clear to you. So, let us see. Okay, we were having this question and we have to divide this polynomial by this polynomial. This we have given in the statement. We have been given it here. This was the statement that we have to divide this polynomial by this polynomial. So, this is the Px here and this is x minus 1. So, and as you can see that here the degree of Px is greater than or equal to 1 because degree here is 4. Okay, so our first line of remainder theorem is clear, that is its degree should be greater than or equal to 1. Now moving on to second line, A be any real number if Px is divided by x minus A. Here what we have written that if Px is divided by x minus A, this is the second line of the theorem, Px is divided by x minus A. So as you can see here, this was Px and it was divided by x minus 1 here. But according to remainder theorem, Px should be divided by x minus a. That means in this question, we are having Px, okay, we are having x also, but what is the value of a in this question? So from here we can see that a is 1 here, okay. Now moving on to next step of remainder theorem, that is next step we have just summarized the wording here. We have just written if Px is divided by x minus a, as in our question we are having this Px and this x minus 1. So from here we can see that the value of A is equals to 1. Okay. Now moving on, what is the next line of the remainder theorem? It states that the remainder will be Pa. Pa means here the value of A is 1. So if you put the value P1, that means if you put the value of variable 1 here, so after solving the value, what will be the result? The result will be the remainder. Okay. So kindly understand the last line properly. Px is divided by x minus a. This is clear. Now remainder is Pa. Remainder is Pa ka matlab hai ki if you place the value of a in the polynomial, then the result we get is the remainder. And the value of a here is 1. So that means we have to put the value of x, or we can say we have to put the value of a in the polynomial. We are having the value of a is 1, so we have to put this value 1 in the polynomial variables. Okay, so let us see what we will get in the answer. Moving on, here as you can see a is 1, so we have written pa is equals to p1. Now our polynomial was this. What we have to do now, we have to replace x by 1. We have to replace now x by 1. So, wherever we are having x, we have replaced it by 1. So, the answer we will get is minus 5. And as you can see, this answer is same as the question, as the answer of long division method. Now, from here, we just have learned that we have to put the value of Pa in the polynomial and the result will be the remainder. Now this is the same case as we have done by the example in the previous slide, that how can we say that this is the remainder. So let us see its proof, that what we can do. Px is equals to x minus a, that is dividend divisor, quotient and remainder. So what we have to do, we have to make the divisor 0. That is, I have explained you in the previous example where we have taken the value of x is equals to 1 to make it 0. So if here we are having x minus a, तो x की हम क्या वैल्यू पुट करें कि हमें इस पूरे पॉलिनोमियल की वैल्यू ज़ीरो मिले. सो इफ x अगर x की वैल्यू अगर a होगी तो a माइनस a इज़ ज़ीरो. सो दैट मीन्स वी हैव पुट x इज इक्वल्स टू a है. अगर हम x की वैल्यू a पुट करते हैं सो वी विल गेट द डिवाइजर ज़ीरो. नाउ इन द प्रीवियस एग्जाम्पल वी हैव डन, वी हैव पुट x इज इक्वल्स टू 1 इन बोथ साइड ऑफ इक्वेशन. सो सिमिलर इज द केस हेयर, वी हैव टू पुट x इज इक्वल्स टू a ऑन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन. सो इफ यू पुट x इज इक्वल्स टू a हेयर, वट विल इट बिकम p a, एंड हेयर इट विल बिकम a माइनस a, एंड इट विल बिकम कोशेंट, एंड इट इज द रिमाइंडर. नाउ एज यू कैन सी a माइनस a इज 0, सो 0 इंटू समथिंग इज 0, सो दिस कंप्लीट टर्म बिकम 0 हेयर एंड रिमाइंडर इज एज इट इज. Now as you can see what we are left with, we are left with p a here. That means we have put the value of a in the polynomial and this is equals to the remainder. So this is a just simple step that whatever question you are given, I am summarizing it in the short, that whatever polynomial you have been given, so you just have to put the divisor is equals to 0. So whatever value you get from there, the value of x, y, z, whatever variable you have been given, you just have to put that value in the dividend. So after solving the value, you will get the remainder. So this was all about the remainder theorem. And based on this, I have solved a question here. That is, you are given a two polynomials and you have to see whether it is completely divided by it or not. So what will you do here? That you will make the divisor 0. So if divisor, for divisor to be 0, x should be equal to minus 1, okay? So now you have to put this minus 1 value into the dividend. So after solving it, what will you get? After solving the value, you will get the 2 here. So that means our remainder is 2, okay? And as you can see, this also follow the remainder theorem because this was our polynomial and this is x minus a. So x की वैल्यू कितनी है, माइनस 1. सो वी हैव पुट दिस वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू अवर a. सो वी हैव रिटन हेयर x माइनस a एंड r, व्हाट विल बी द रिमाइंडर, रिमाइंडर इज इक्वल टू p a, एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ a हेयर, माइनस 1. सो यू हैव टू पुट द वैल्यू जस्ट माइनस 1 इन द पॉलिनोमियल एंड योर रिजल्ट विल बी रिमाइंडर. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दिस रिमाइंडर थ्योरम यू हैव टू डू द क्वेश्चन आई एम गिविंग यू. देर इज जस्ट अ सिंगल क्वेश्चन, यू हैव टू चेक वेदर दिस पॉलिनोमियल is a multiple of this. I have told you in the starting class of this chapter that there are two terms, where first is multiple and second is factor. So based on both these concepts, you have to solve this question. You have to tell that whether this polynomial is a multiple of this polynomial. For example, 12 is equals to 6 into 2. 12 is the multiple of 6 and also 2. That means 12 come in the table of this. That means 12 is completely divisible by 6. So this is a hint I am giving you that you have to tell whether this is a multiple of this or not. Multiple means it should be completely divisible by this. So you just have to find it out whether it is multiple or it is not a multiple of this. So just there is a one question as your practice, and else you have to go through the video properly and note down the every question or example in your notebook, and also the remainder theorem in your notebook. So that's all for today.